Hi, this is Judy from Los Angeles, and today I want to talk about a very interesting topic and about uplifting each other. Do you practice this, or do you tear others down so that you can look better? There are people in this world who do nothing but look for faults in people. And they never see any goodness in people. I see it with many people who don't support me or they don't support others. And what happens? This kind of people, what they do is they attack instead of really looking at supporting that person. So they use attack methods just to put you down. And I'm going to talk about an honest opinion I have. This I have observed. I live in Los Angeles, and I have seen it in the Americas. When I lived in Africa, I saw it in Africa. I do have a lot of friends from the Caribbeans, and I've seen it in the Caribbeans. And as I travel around the world, which I have gone to many places, I see this disease that is common among my people. And this could be common among other races. The problem is I don't know because I am not in their circle. So I hang out with my own people. So I'm gonna refer to my people because that is the background I know best. One of the things that happens to a lot of us Black people, when one of us does well, we either compete or find every way to criticize that person. We do everything in our power to bring them down and not to embrace each other. We don't embrace each other in any ways for us to grow to higher growths. And I am generalizing because there's a few people in our communities who do practice this support. So whatever I'm talking about, I'm generalizing, and this is something that really seems to happen on a bigger level and not on the smaller level. So yes, I am generalizing. So one of the problems that I've noticed among my people, we do not think multipliers. Instead, we tear each other down. And for example, when one of us gets a promotion, you find a way to go behind the scenes and say something about that person so that that person, even if they had an opportunity to be promoted, they end up not getting the promotion because you are doing everything to tear them down. And the few of us who seem to go a little higher, they become very scared, and you find that they are very afraid to pull our people of our race to those levels because they fear that you're going to tear them down. So it's not a one-way street. I think it's a double street, whereby if they do climb up, the other people down tear them down, and when they go up, they actually forget about the people they left behind. We don't think multipliers. We don't think if I had 3-4 people up there, then that would be a support for me. A friend of mine was telling me about crabs in a bucket. I had no idea, but you know, after she explained it, I was like, oh my God, that is so sad, but that sounds more like who we are. The crabs, when you put them in a bucket, if they just calm down, they can really crawl out of the bucket. But most of them just fight each other and remain down. When one tries to climb, another one pulls them down, so they can just remain in that bucket and become meat, become a food for the person who caught the crabs. And we do practice that without really knowing what we are doing. instead of really, if they got a ladder and lifted each other up, by the time the fisherman comes around, they may have crawled out of the crab. But unfortunately, they don't think like that. They don't think multiplier. They think, how can we tear down everybody? How can we, one of us, not go up? In life, we're always one person may, not all black people are down there. A few have made it. We have Obama who has made it. But as Obama tried to go, some people were like, he's not dark-skinned enough. He was raised white. And he's not black enough. So we find every opportunity to find something that will tear instead of really building him up and really putting him in a pedestal and asking him, how did you do it? So that the people who are aspiring to be president can be presidents. But instead, we just want to sit over there and just remain in poverty. So long as our friends, our people are suffering, we seem to thrive in that community. So long as we are all in the ghetto and nobody leaves the ghetto, we seem to really like that environment. But when one of us just leaves the ghetto, you start really hating that person. The jealousy takes over and it really gets to you. And I'm starting to believe that oppression, one of the things the oppressors had, they got right, was one factor, and the factor of only one. And what the oppressors did, there was only one, there was only one person in the house while others worked in the field. There was only, when you look in Africa, you get that there's only one family that rules for years, come on. Their children rule, and just one. And then also, if it's not one family, you get that it's only one tribe that seems to rule, one or two tribes that take over, and they just rule and rule, and they just never find an opportunity to include anybody else. So instead of really being inclusive and looking at how can we multiply, how can we have more of us here, because it's amazing, you know, the good Lord did not make us with all the skills. Everybody has different skills. So if we had different people to move up, it's amazing how the society will be complete in itself, because at that point they'll be able to make different scenarios. We seem to be in a dysfunction because if one person got it wrong, the dysfunction, then the people who move up in Africa, like the presidents, it's the same blood, the same thinking, the same everything. So they continuously make the same mistakes over and over and over. And soon you never see a change. And 60 years after independence, you're just rotating in the same place. So the systems of oppression have one big thing in common: sabotage. And I don't know how they did this, but this has worked among my people. Half of my people are down because they use a lot of sabotage among themselves. When you go to South Central, you hear black and black killings. No longer even the other way, but black on black crimes. Chicago, in South Africa, they don't want the black people trying to get jobs there, which I do understand that's a topic for another day. But if another person who is of a different color comes into South Africa, they look at it like they're an investor. That is the systems of oppression. You are just supposed to be down there, and none of you people or people that look at you need to move up. So amongst ourselves, rather than support, we sabotage. Rather than collaborate, we compete. Rather than celebrate, we ridicule. And my friends, my people, unless we change, we will never move to any high levels. We will remain there. What has happened with the systems of oppression? It's like a cancer. It's like a cancer. It's like a virus. we have this virus, like coronavirus. And a virus, when you hear the scientists talk, and I'm not a scientist by any chance, but when I hear them talk, they talk of a virus multiplying quickly in your body to kill all the good cells, and then they take over your body and you become diseased. So one of the counteractions is to give you a vaccination. They vaccinate you so that it can kill. You have your white cells that can come and kill the virus. And we have to find ways in which we can fight the systems of oppression. And by fighting them is just making sure when that negativity starts cropping into your mind, when you start thinking, compete, you're like, okay, let me collaborate. Just like on my TV channel, ATLE TV, I'm looking for people who want to collaborate with me. I'm looking for people who have good, humorous, entertaining, as well as empowerment. Our theme is, how can we empower ourselves? How can we be able to tell our stories? So let's work on killing that oppression virus and see how we can really start looking at what is good among us. When you look at somebody, there's this strengths perspective theory. If you haven't read that, please go read about it. Because what I like about the strengths perspective is not looking at the deficit in people, but looking at their strengths. Because when we look at each other's strength, not all of us have the same powers. Some of us may be good in mathematics, others may be good in science, others may be good doctors, others may be good teachers, but all these systems need each other to sustain. So let us not compete. The fact that God didn't give you a good brain for biology and anatomy is difficult for you, but you're the best mathematician ever, you actually need to collaborate so that you can do great things. Let's support each other and build each other for a greater and stronger survival of our people. This is a topic that I really want us to practice. And one of the things that I notice is I start by just subscribing on my channel, ATLE TV. If you want to collaborate and also be on this channel and say your topics, definitely we are going to showcase as many people as possible because it's a big channel. It's huge. And not only Judy can talk about these topics. Judy can talk about some aspects of these topics. But I need other people who have empowering messages to contact me so that we can be able to teach each other on how we can really kill this virus of oppression. Because we become slaves of ourselves. And instead of really looking forward and supporting each other and thriving so that we can reach higher heights. Thank you so much. Thanks for watching. Subscribe. Judy Lai from Los Angeles. Thank you.